Family, welcome and thank you for being here on this important day. We are gathered together to celebrate the very special love between Karen and Carl by joining them together. This is an opportunity for us to share not only in the joy of love, but also to reaffirm and appreciate the love and the friendship we experience in our own lives. May we all celebrate by being fully present with Karen and Carl. May every desire you have for your love be fulfilled, and may you be given the vision with which to clearly behold one another, the listening with which to perceive one another most genuinely, and the endless generosity of spirit with which to nourish one another and sweetly keep the promises you make here today. From Corinthians. If I speak in the tongues of men and angels, but have not love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have a faith that can move mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor, and surrender my body to the flames, but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. And it is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. Where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when perfection comes, the imperfect disappears. When I was a child, I talked like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I put childish ways behind me. Now we see but a poor reflection as in a mirror. Then we shall see face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall know fully, even as I am fully known. And now these three remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. Carl and Karen, I remind you that this union is a precious gift, a lifelong commitment, and a challenge to love one another more completely each and every day. Carl, with this understanding, do you take Karen to be your wife, to live together in unity? Do you promise to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, and to be faithful only to her, so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Karen, with this understanding, do you take Carl to be your husband, to live together in unity? Do you promise to love him, comfort him, honor and keep him, for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, and to be faithful only to him so long as you both shall live?
I do.
May I have the rings, please? The ring, an unbroken, never-ending circle, is a symbol of committed, unending love. Carl, as you place this ring on Karen's finger, repeat these words after me. This ring, a gift for you.
This ring, a gift for you.
Symbolizes my desire.
Symbolizes my desire.
That you be my wife.
That you be my wife.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
As this ring has no end.
As this ring has no end.
Neither shall my love for you.
Neither shall my love for you.
Karen, as you place this ring on Carl's finger, repeat these words after me. This ring, a gift for you.
This ring, a gift for you.
Symbolizes my desire.
Symbolizes my desire.
That you be my husband.
That you be my husband.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
As this ring has no end.
As this ring has no end.
Neither shall my love for you.
Neither shall my love for you.
Karen and Carl have chosen to affirm their love by the lighting of a unity candle. They have also asked their families to participate in the lighting ceremony. In so doing, they signal their desire to not only join as one in their union, but to unite two families together as one. I want to take a moment to explain what the lighting of the candles represents to them. From every human being, there arises a light, and when two souls that are destined for each other find one another, their streams of light flow together, and a single brighter light goes forth from their united being. I now invite Karen and Carl's moms to light the family candle. Karen and Carl, the brightness of the candles that your families lit And the brightness of the unity candle that you will together light will shine throughout your lives, giving you courage and reassurance in the darkness. May the candle's warmth give you shelter from the cold. May its energy fill your spirits with strength and joy. As you light the unity candle, I want to ask you and all your friends and family that are present today to see the brightness of the flame as a symbol of the brightness that your own life brings to this new family. May your love for each other light up your life as a family. The final act of this ceremony is the shattering of the glass. This old custom has many traditions with many interpretations. At one time, it was meant to scare off demons that frequent celebrations or pesky wedding guests. Today, the fragility of the glass suggests the frailty of human relationships, just as permanent and final as the breaking of this glass is unchangeable. The glass is broken to protect this marriage with the implied prayer, may your bond of love be as difficult to break as it would be to put back together the pieces of glass. Knowing that this marriage is permanent, Carl and Karen should strive every day to show each other love and respect and happiness. After Carl and Karen break the glass, I invite everyone to shout the Hebrew words Mazel Tov, meaning good luck and congratulations.
I should have done 2 feet.
Next.
May Carl and Karen be to each other a blessing and comfort, sharer of joys and consoler of sorrows. May they, trusting in the strength of their union, face life unafraid, supporting and encouraging each other in whatever they set out to achieve. May the inspiration of this ceremony not be forgotten. May Carl and Karen dream big dreams, love like there's no tomorrow, and become the best people they know how to be. Today, Carl and Karen have declared before all of us that they shall be together in marriage. They have vowed to be loyal and loving towards each other. They have demonstrated the bond between them with words spoken and with the giving and receiving of rings. Therefore, it is my pleasure to now pronounce them husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
Thank you. marriage go together like a horse and carriage. This I tell you, brother, you can't have one without the other. Love and marriage, love and marriage, it's an institute you can't disparage. Ask the local gentry and they will say it's elementary. Try, try, try to separate them, it's an illusion.
We'd like to bring in the mother of the bride, Mary Brill, escorted by Joe Wheeler, and the father of the bride, Jeff Brill.
Why must I just give you your way? Why do I sigh? Why don't I try to forget? It must have been that something lovers call fate.